My name is Carol Glinski, and my husband and I, John, helped to oversee the youth ministry and lead a young married's small group in the North Side. We have three incredible kids, Aria, who's 16, Ella, who's 14, and Case, who's 12. And I'm super excited to be able to share with you about the spiritual discipline of giving. Giving is such an important part of what God wants us to participate in as a Christian, honestly, just to be able to understand and give and see who He is more. We're going to talk a little bit deeper, but the reason why and how we see God and how that affects what we think about and how we and why and how we give. So we're going to look at Matthew 25 verses 14 through 30, and I'm going to read it quickly. It says, "Again, it will be like a man going on a journey who called his servants and entrusted his wealth to them. To one he gave 5 bags of gold, to another 2 bags, to another 1 bag, each according to his ability. Then he went on his journey. The man who had received 5 bags of gold went at once and put his money to work and gained 5 more. The one also with 2 bags went and gained 2 more. But the man who had received 1 bag went off, dug a hole in the ground, and hid his master's money. After a long time, the master of those servants returned and settled accounts with them. The man who had received 5 bags of gold brought the other 5. Master, he said, you entrusted me with 5 bags of gold. See, I've gained 5 more. His master replied, well done, good and faithful servant. You have been faithful with a few things. I will put you in charge of many things. Come and share your master's happiness. The man with 2 bags of gold also came. Master, he said, you've entrusted me with 2 bags of gold. See, I've gained 2 more. His master replied, well done, good and faithful servant. You've been faithful with a few things, and I'll put you in charge of more. Come and share in your master's happiness. Then the man who had received 1 bag of gold came. Master, he said, I know that you're a hard man, harvesting where you have not sown and gathering where you have not scattered seed. So I was afraid and went out and hid your gold in the ground. See, here is what belongs to you. His master replied, you wicked, lazy servant. So you knew that I harvest where I have not sown and gather where I have not scattered seed. Well then, you should have put my money on deposit with a banker so that when I returned, I would have received it back with interest. So take the bag of gold from him and give it to the one with 10 bags. For whoever has will be given more, and they will have an abundance. Whoever does not have, even what they have will be taken from them. And throw that worthless servant outside into the darkness where there will be weeping and gnashing of teeth." That's an intense story, right? So I look at these three guys. How did these men see their master? The first two, think about it, even though they had different amounts of money that were given to them, they put it to work. And they said immediately, they went happily going and doing it. There had to be this faith and trust in the giver, right? That he believes in them and that they're able to go and do the work. And they were able to double their investment. The third servant saw his master as a hard man who takes and is greedy. So this perspective gave him fear, and he chose to store it away so that he could just return it to him. I used to read this as the third servant, that he just did nothing with it. He just, you know, squandered it and wasted it away. But he did something, actually. He goes and he digs a hole and hides it. And I think sometimes we can go and do something with what we have, or go and give, but if we're giving out of fear, then really we need to check that, because that's not what God is intending. He wants us to go with joy and trust in Him. So how we see God is vital to how we give. If we see God as a God of abundance and a giver of good things, we'll trust Him and joyfully give back to Him and to others, fulfilling the greatest commandment, right? To love God and to love other people. Or if we see God as a God who is waiting to watch us fail, or that there isn't enough for everybody, then we're gonna hoard things and not trust God. So I wanna challenge you to look at your thoughts, and your thoughts about God when it comes to giving, and how much you give and why you give. And to see if you lack trust in God in these areas, and to see if your thought processes are scared or there's this fear there, and to look into that. So let's look closely at verse 29. It says, "For whoever has will be given more, and they will have in abundance. Whoever does not have, even what they have will be taken from them." I always used to read this with so much confusion, like, how in the world will you know, can you take something away from someone who has nothing? Impossible. Like, you can't take away from nothing. There's nothing, right? But the thing is that he actually didn't, he had something. The guy with one bag had something, but he thought he had nothing. And because he thought he had nothing, then even those things that he actually had were taken from him. And the reality is if we have this mindset, it sucks away, and it takes away from the things that we have and the way that we can even give and what we can do with that. So I'll tell you a quick story about myself. I grew up pretty poor. We lived in a bus. I had five siblings. There's so much more to the story, right? But I became a disciple at the age of 14. I didn't have an allowance. We didn't have that money. But my parents would actually give me about $2 a week to go and buy a hamburger and fries, right? Because I would go and play a volleyball or a basketball game every week. So I thought, well, how can I give back to God? So I thought to myself, you know what I'm gonna do? I'm just gonna not eat fries and save that $1, and so I can actually give back to God, right? To give it as an offering, something that cost me something that was hard for me, but it was good. And it's not like I told everybody, and even I guess telling you this maybe not great, but I was happy to give it. You know why? Because I thought it's not a lot, but for me it was a lot, right? And it was so important for my heart to give, but I was able to give because I knew I was going to be taken care of. I knew I had enough. I knew even though we were poor, we were always taken care of. I always had all that I needed. And so it really is super important that we think that way, that we think about how we give, and not that we're just giving a little, but that we give faithfully and something that can be even more than we believe because we trust God. So one of the things here is that I really want us to remember that God is a creator. He created us, right? He created this world for us to enjoy. He created you to create. God is a compassionate and gracious God, slow to anger, abounding in love, right? The Psalms say that. And I want you to actually think about this. Commit this to memory. Psalm 103 verse 8, and Psalm 145 verse 8, they say that. They say those things out loud every morning and every night. And I love you guys. I pray that you will see who God is, that He is a compassionate and gracious God, slow to anger, abounding in love, so that you'll trust Him and give in all areas of your life. I love you guys. I'll talk to you later. Bye.